because I am so excited that he is here today. We have made our way into our kitchen, and our next guest has 13 James Beard Awards, which is huge, but 13 for his writing and his reporting, and has a brand new book, Pizza City USA, 101 Reasons Why Chicago is America's Greatest Pizza Town. Today, he is making a classic deep dish pizza that is mouthwatering, and I cannot wait to sink my teeth into. Please welcome Steve Dolinsky to our home.
That's a big deal. I love that you're so excited about deep dish pizza. That's a really cool deal.
We're all very excited, as is everyone here. Our entire family is joining us here at the counter. That one slice is like six slices, which is so exciting.
A little Afghan for your stomach, yeah.
Yeah, it's like a little blanket. So you've been writing about food for decades and doing very well with it, by the way, with your 13 awards, James Beard Awards. Why turn your eye to pizza?
I had seen one of those listicles online of the 7 hottest pizza places in Chicago, and I had been to a couple of them that week before, and I thought, this is just not right. There's no research that's being done. Who's vetting this? And so I thought I would tackle it once and for all and just try to get to the bottom of who makes the best pizza, where is the best pizza in Chicago, and what are the styles of pizza? It's more than deep dish in Chicago. It's tavern style, Neapolitan, Detroit, Sicilian. There's a lot of different pizza styles in Chicago. So, but of course, deep dish is what we're known for. 1943, it started there, and then stuffed came in 1974. But I argue in the book that tavern style, which we'll talk about in a little bit, is the Chicago style.
Mm. I mean, that was only a list of 7. You have 185 in your book, so that was a lot of research and development.
There's 101 that I recommend, but there are 10 styles we talk about in the book.
Okay. Yeah,
every chapter is a different style. So there's thin, there's tavern style, Neapolitan, Sicilian, artisan, Roman, Detroit, yeah.
101 you recommend, but then 80 some plus that you do not recommend. Which is good. So he tells you what not to do as well.
Just imagine the research that goes into it. Yeah.
We were doing three days for a couple of months in a row.
Oh my God.
Did you gain weight?
I did. Yeah. Yeah. I did. I had acid reflux issues. I went to core power yoga every other day.
Oh my God.
You are committed, my friend.
All right. Okay. So we're starting to make this beautiful pizza right now. You've already started with the dough. We have a beautiful dough here. So tell us how got the dough to this spot.
So this is from La Briola in Chicago, my favorite deep dish right now. And the dough is really important. And there's corn flour in this. There's some corn oil in this. It's just all-purpose flour.
Okay.
But the important thing is it takes about a day to make this because once you mix the dough, you got to let it rest for 2.5 hours, goes in the refrigerator overnight. The next morning, you've got about a 3-hour resting time. There's a part where we put the dough ball in the middle. Now, this Chicago Metallic pan, it's called Chicago Metallic. You find these online. We'd line it with olive oil and then some of this coarse cornmeal. Very important to have coarse cornmeal. Most pizzas in Chicago have coarse cornmeal underneath. It's texture. It's crunch.
Yes.
It also keeps it from sticking.
Smart.
So that's part of this. So then after you wait a half an hour, you push it out. You wait another hour, you push it out some more. You can see it's kind of delicate now and it's kind of soft. The yeast is doing its magic in there.
Okay,
so now that it's pushed all the way to the edge.
I find really fascinating now that we have our dough in the pan where it needs to be, we put the cheese before we put the sauce.
Very important with deep dish. The construction is totally different than what you think. It should always be cheese on top. And so we have this thick 2-ounce slices of whole milk mozzarella. None of this part skim, shredded stuff.
All the way up to the
We're going to kind of kiss the inside of this pan because we want that to fall down along the inside perimeter. That's going to be
a little bit of cheese.
That's that little dark cheesy crust cracker you have on the side. It's not burnt dough, it's burnt cheese. This is inspired by places like Pequod's in Chicago, almost like Detroit style pizza, if you've seen that as well. You have that caramelized burnt edge. So you're going to cover
the whole thing. And this guy right in the middle?
Yep. So there's about 24 ounces of cheese right there.
Always whole milk
mozzarella.
Okay, now we have our special sauce, which is not just any tomato sauce. This one's very interesting.
It's a couple different tomatoes. So at La Briola, they combine their thin sauce, which has got ground tomatoes and tomato puree and some dried oregano and dried basil and some salt and sugar and a little pinch of cayenne with some other tomatoes that have been skinned and sliced that have drained for 3 hours. So they're very dry and chunky. That is this sauce here. They also make a mirepoix, which is a fancy word for carrots, onions, and celery that they cook for about 10 minutes until it's soft and translucent. And they puree that and mix that in here.
Exhausting.
And it gives it some body, some backbone, a little bit of, I think it just makes it sophisticated.
It elevates it.
Okay,
just listening to you, I think
so
we're more sophisticated.
So we are going to put this
just
on
right
top.
With your hands.
Yeah, why not?
Just get in there with your hands. Why not? Okay, I've got napkins over here. Don't worry.
Clean hands, as Julia Child would say, they are immaculately clean. So we're going to just kind of... No, we're
all
not
the
gonna,
way to the edges?
Not all the way to the edge. We're going to leave about a half inch perimeter. We don't want this sauce to go down the side, right? We want just that cheese.
Okay.
So that's it, kind of chunky. And you can see there's oregano and there's a little bit of basil in there. And that is just delicious. Now, the sausage. This is kind of the star of the show. In Chicago, unlike New York or the East Coast, we do bulk sausage, fennel sausage in here. We love fennel in our sausage. There's a little bit of cayenne in here, inspired by La Briola's history goes back to Italo Russo, as a gentleman who made sausage for his dad, Danny. And so they always make this bulk sausage, and we call pinch and press.
Just like that, always.
Always
pinch
and press.
This is how they do it?
So on the East Coast, you'll find, like, if you go get a slice of pizza, it's typically cheese.
Or pepperoni.
Or pepperoni. But if you get a sausage, it's going to be a link, sliced, looking like a disc or a coin, with very little flavor. I think kind of mild, like a breakfast sausage. In Chicago, it's always pinched and pressed. There's a little bit of heat. There's quite a bit of fat in here. This is going to render...
I've never met anyone who knows more about pizza in my life.
This is amazing.
I've done a fair amount of eating.
I feel like we're going to Pizza University.
We are. Pizza 101, or maybe it's 303. I'm not sure.
I'm in a graduate course.
But I like the jagged edges of this, okay? So you get some nooks and crannies, and it's got a little
bit
of heat in there. And it's very rustic.
Okay.
So that is going to be beautiful once that
gets
in there as well.
Now our final layer.
Okay, final thing, a couple things I'm going to give these, because I know the Greeks love oregano. That's part of your food.
Lots of Greeks in Chicago, by the way. Greek town's really great in Chicago.
So I know part of you, it's like you have yogurt, you have honey, you have coffee and souvlaki, and you've got oregano.
We have oregano.
There you go.
Wait a minute, let's not forget the olives.
And the olives, right.
There you go.
So dried oregano and then some Pecorino Romano cheese, because it's salty and a little firm and just a little bit of a contrast to that creamy, rich mozzarella. This gives it another dimension, okay? So this is going to go into the oven now.
Okay, now here's the thing. If you don't have a pizza oven...
You don't need a pizza oven. You need a hot oven. So crank it all the way up 5:30 if you can. You need a pizza stone, though. That is the important part. So the stone does two things. When you're baking, if it's just a raw, if it's a thin pie, it's going to pull some of that moisture out and give you that crispy bottom, because it's a porous material. But the most important thing
stone
is so heavy.
It is heavy.
4 pounds. Stone is a great conductor of heat. So when this hits, even though this is insulated. Anodized steel, it hits that stone. It starts baking immediately. That's why the bottom of that pizza is firm and crisp.
It's crunchy.
So this goes into a hot oven. I'm going to take these because it's kind of warm.
That is so beautiful, Steve.
Right. We're going to take this.
Oh, my gosh. So you said 500 degrees?
If you can get to 530, that would be great.
For how long?
That's good.
About 40 to 45 minutes.
Wow.
Okay. And you want to check it at 30, though?
Check it about 35, because if you're only doing it at 500 degrees, you might get too black around the edges. You want to cover it with tin foil.
If it starts to get too black, cover it, put it back in.
Exactly. Okay.
Oh,
so now I'm going to take a little spatula. We're going to go around. We're going to just separate it.
Like a work of art.
We're going to take this.
It really is.
Hopefully I do them.
The texture.
Do you need this help with this
flavors. Yeah. It's like unbelievable.
I can get this. This is a little trickier than I thought.
And did you do any research by working in any of these
kitchens?
I did not, but I should.
But you do tours, right?
Here
you're
we
such
go.
A pizza.
My Game of Thrones here.
Okay.
The House of Stark.
Okay, wait. What is this called?
This is a mezzaluna.
That is. And is it only for pizza?
Yeah. You got to have one of these guys to do some damage here. You got to cut through. This is serious.
Okay, Steve, you came from Chicago. I know that wasn't in our kitchen. Was that a carry-on?
We sent this. It's not a carry-on. You had to send this baby.
Oh, my God.
I got to ask, you're planning this incredible work of art. You also, as a pizza pro, you do tours around Chicago. You lead tours.
Yep. Every weekend, Pizza City USA tours. We do 4 tours every weekend. Every tour is 4 different styles of pizza in about 3 hours. So I lead a bus tour on Saturdays. We have 3 walking tours on the weekends. But the main thing is you see 4 styles of pizza in 3 hours, because I didn't want to just show deep dish. I mean, deep is part of the tours, but I want to show that we have Neapolitan and we have tavern style and we have Sicilian and other great pizzas in Chicago. It is a serious pizza town, but this, of course, is our most famous. This is like the Times Square of Chicago. You check that box when you come visit.
Yep.
How does your deep dish stack up against some of these ones in Chicago that you're touring people? I mean,
this is from La Briola. This is my favorite one. I mean, again, a lot of the cornmeal, the corn flour, the corn oil.
Right, Debbie?
We love our corn in the Midwest.
Look, she's losing it.
I think I love you, Steve.